Hey, my name is Christopher Farron. I'm an independent coffee consultant and director of coffee for Phoenix Coffee in Cleveland, Ohio, here with Leaderboard. The coffee we submitted is one from our exposure series that we're calling Koji Supernatural. So if you got this one right, you probably got the answer on the back too. Well done. This coffee comes to us from a farm in Tolima, Colombia called El Vergel, and is processed using a novel processing technique that we refer to as Koji processing. I devised it for Finland's barista champion ahead of his presentation at World Barista Championships in Milan in 2021. In this method, we take coffee cherry and we inoculate it with spores of a mold typically called koji, which is traditionally used to produce foods like miso, shoyu, and sake. What it does is, through its metabolism, it produces enzymes that will degrade proteins into amino acids like glutamate and starches into fermentable sugars, which can then be fermented by secondary organisms like yeast or bacteria. So what we found, even though this is a new processing technique and we're still working to refine it, is that it tends to create a round mouthfeel and a long, sparkly finish, almost like it sprinkled a little bit of MSG in the cup. So even though this is a Caturra, one of the most commonly planted traditional cultivars in Colombia and grown at a fairly low altitude of about 1300 to 1350 meters, I think you'll be surprised to find that this cup has incredible depth, complexity, structure, and sweetness. It's a dry process coffee, so it's going to appear visually less uniform than if it were a wet processed coffee. And I think a few folks have noted on here that there are a few elephant shells here and there. It's a very small lot, so we didn't get to run it through the big mill. We roast it hot and fast on a loring, so there's not much chaff to speak of, and the development is fairly light. And because the coffee is pretty low density as well, it gives it a little bit more of a mottled appearance than you might expect. I like to brew it using a filter or percolation method, targeting about 22 to 23% extraction, generally looking at a 1 to 17 ratio with 100 degree water fresh off a boil. I've also had a lot of success using low bypass brews or long steeps with ratios between 1 to 18 and 1 to 20, but if you're super adventurous and have a way to do it, highly recommend doing a low pressure turbo with a ratio of 1 to 2 for an altogether very new espresso experience. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. See you on the cupping table.